So our lab is interested in children who have hearing loss that is not severe in nature, so mild to moderately severe. These are our typical hearing aid users. And we're interested in the school age population. So there's a lot of research that's going on in the early years from birth to about 6 or 7 years old. And we're interested in what happens after that as children progress through school. And so we started going out to the classrooms for different research purposes and noticed that there were a good number of the kids that we were seeing that weren't wearing their hearing aids when they were in school learning. And so we wanted to more systematically document whether or not they were using their hearing aids. There's some great research that's been coming out over the last couple years that's used parent report and data logging to document exactly how long during the day or the use time for the children who are birthed to 6 or 7 years of age, and shows that as the children get older, they are more likely to wear their hearing aids throughout the day. However, the trend doesn't really continue as the children grow older, and that's really the question that we wanted to answer with this study, was can we document whether or not children, as they progress through school after they enter elementary school, whether or not they're wearing those hearing aids. For the most part, the children in grades 1st through 4th were pretty good hearing aid users. So we went out to the classrooms and we just observed them a couple different times during the day and on 2 separate school days that were typical school days. And we found that the 1st through 4th graders were good hearing aid users. Every time we went out, they were pretty much using their hearing aids. However, when we went to the classrooms of the 5th graders, the 6th graders, and the 7th graders, that wasn't always the case. And only about 50% of those kids in that grade level were wearing their hearing aids in the classroom. So we brought a poster to ASHA a couple years ago, and it was really our first presentation of how the children with hearing loss, when they got into those older grades, they weren't wearing their hearing aids. And a lot of us audiologists who work on the project and who were talking to other audiologists, we were kind of surprised, because we have these kids coming into clinic and we ask them and their parents, are you wearing your hearing aids in the classroom? And they say, yeah, yep, we are. However, if you talk to other people who see these children every day and not just once or twice a year, they are very, very aware that the children aren't wearing their hearing aids in the classroom. So at this poster session where we first showed our results of the older children not wearing their hearing aids in the classroom, we had a lot of speech pathologists come up and a lot of other clinicians and service providers come up who are working daily with these children, and they were not surprised in the slightest. And it sparked some really interesting conversation that really highlights the importance of cross-disciplinary discussion, especially when we're talking about serving the same child, because it may be that the audiologist can really help their practice decisions for that child if they also team up with the other service providers that the child works with. And that was not an unexpected finding, but it was certainly one that we didn't set out to uncover. We also asked parents whether or not the children were wearing their hearing aids. So we know from research with younger children that parents often overestimate the child's hearing aid use time, and that overestimation is usually about 2 hours. So if the parent says, oh yes, my little Johnny wears his hearing aids 10 hours a day, it's really probably only about 8 hours a day on average. However, we asked the parents how long their children wore their hearing aids during the day and in this older group of kids, and what we found is that the parents who had 5th, 6th, and 7th grade students were much more likely to overestimate the hearing aid use than the children or the parents of the children in the younger grade levels. We need to have further research so that we can figure out how to better examine why there's this discrepancy between the parent report and what we're actually seeing from the children in the classroom. And the first step may be to start asking the teachers to see if the teachers are agreeing with the parents or if they're aware that the child should be wearing a hearing aid, and so on and so forth. So there's some really nice data coming out that shows younger children who are fit with well-fit hearing aids and they wear them consistently throughout their early childhood, they actually do develop better speech and language. And that is great news. It's very intuitive news that, you know, we've been thinking, oh, of course, that's duh information for us for a long time, but we've just now gotten the solid evidence to show that. However, we don't know what the negative impact might be or what the positive impact might be of not using or using your hearing aids during these later adolescent periods in life. And one of the factors that will surely probably come into play is the more psychosocial factors of things that impact a child's decision to do one action over the other, such as wearing the hearing aid versus not wearing the hearing aid, joining the swim team versus not joining the swim team. All of those decisions are complicated by social factors and emotional factors and self-esteem and all of the different things that make our older children so interesting to work with. But it also complicates the picture of, you know, why they're making those decisions and how those decisions are going to impact them going forward.